This is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time I'm trying out the War of the Outer Gods with the variant that came in the pamphlet. So there is a variant to change the scenario up a bit at the end. So how it works is that I play as usual, but when determining the warring order, I will randomize it. There is an option to randomize it at the start, but I thought to make it more chaotic to randomize it every turn. So every enemy phase, I will re-randomize the order. Or actually, I think it's better to randomize it at the start of the mythos phase. So first turn, they act as normal. Then after that, every mythos phase, I reorder the order where Doom gets added and in which order the factions work. So these tokens are representing the order, so they don't play as anything else. So at the start, it's green, blue, red as usual. But then I will pick them up and randomize them. So it would be red, green, blue, for example. But we start at the usual order, just to keep it simple at the start, but starting to make it a bit different after that. I decided to play Silas Marsh for this playthrough. So let's look at Silas's deck first. The deck is a 29 experience deck. It has three basic weaknesses. I ended up drawing Red Curse, Obsessive, and Through the Gates, so nothing really bad, but still, Through the Gates is always a bit hard, as it can remove a really important card from your deck. Other than that, it's a basic Silas Marsh deck. I'm trying out some of the newer cards, like the Chainsaw and Mariner's Compass that came in the latest Mythos pack that has come out for Innsmouth Conspiracy. I'm also trying the new Lucky level 3 and Unexpected Courage level 2 from the Stella Clark Investigator Starter pack. Other than that, it's quite basic Silas Marsh deck, so can fight well, and I have to use some tricks to be able to investigate, so let's see if that becomes a problem. But that is enough of the deck. We are starting in Arkham, and there are three enemies in play as usual. They start moving towards each other as warring enemies, and after the first turn we randomize the order. So let's see how this variant goes. Let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the decks, so let's draw our opening hand. We get Nimble, Inquiring Mind, Old Keyring, Lucky, Unexpected Courage. So at the start, we are not that keen on fighting that much. Maybe we have to deal with the cultist a bit, but I think we can just punch most of these guys. So if they first deal some damage to each other, we can then start punching them. But getting clues at the start is really important, so we'll keep the old keyring. Nimble might be not that useful. To get the clue from Arkham, I think Inquiring Mind is really good. Lucky is really good. It basically guarantees we get that clue. And also, I really like Unexpected Courage. But we really need to get some form of weapon. So I think these are overkill at the start. So let's draw three more cards. Well, we didn't get the weapon. We got the Look What I Found, Madame LaBranche, and Old Keyring. So that is enough shuffling, and well, I'm hoping we can get a weapon soon enough, but let's start our first turn. First action, I play down the keyring. It comes into play with two keys. Costs one resource. I'll play Madame LaBranche. Then I will investigate Arkham. So I'll investigate. It drops down to 5. I'm investigating 2 versus 5. I'll go 4, 5, 6 versus 5. 3. Well, let's count again. Well, I have a 2, so this drops to 3. So I'm 2 versus 3 and 5 versus 3. And we get an Elder Sign. I could commit something from my discard, but there is nothing there yet. So we get the clue. And we lose one key from the keyring. That is the investigation phase. We'll go to enemy phase. So the warring factions move in the current order. Nothing else happens. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get quick thinking and gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. At the start of the mythos phase, I will randomize the faction order. So first faction will be blue, second one is green, and then red. So we just put them here. So we're going up and down. I'm not changing these every turn. So we add doom in faction order. So blue, green, red. And we have to remember to move enemies in that order in the enemy phase. Encounter card for this turn is Zealot of Paradise. So just put it over here. And it spawns up here. Okay. So that is the enemy phase. The mythos phase, let's go to the investigation phase. Okay, let's think about this. So I think we need to kill off the green guys. So these guys won't kill each other yet, but we need to stop the green guys from getting momentum. There is two green enemies in play. So I think first action will move. Actually, I'll use a free action to move by paying. So I'll move to streets of Montreal. So there is one clue here. Double action, deal 3 damage to a non-ancient one enemy at Montreal location in any group, limit once per game. I think first action will be to engage this guy. Second action, I'll hit and I'll commit quick thinking to the test. I am hitting 5 versus 2. It's an Elder Sign, so I commit quick inquiring mind to the test, and I'll actually pull this back. Or should I? Do I need the extra action? I could investigate with the extra action, so let's let that go through. So we deal 1 damage. So we get an extra action. So I'll use that extra action to punch this guy again. And I'll commit Inquiring Mind just in case. I can always pull it back if I fail. Or if I succeed enough. So, we got plus one. So, I'll pull this back with Silas' ability. This enemy is defeated. Then, last action, I will investigate. I'm using the old key ring. I'm committing Inquiring Mind to the test. And it's a skull. It's a minus one for each clue, so it's a minus one. I succeed, I'll get the clue. And that is our turn. We go to the enemy phase, so the new order is blue, moves to Arkham, green moves to my location, and red moves to Arkham. Then blue hits red, red hits green doesn't hit anything, and red hits blue. Okay, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, I get resourceful. At the moment it's not useful, but maybe in some future turn we gain one resource, and that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. And I forgot to use the key last turn, so we discard the keyring. So actually resourceful gets us the keyring back if we need it, but we have another in hand, so maybe not. Okay, so we randomize the order. We have green first, then red, then blue. Okay, so we add the dooms. Green, red, and blue. At the moment this doesn't matter that much, but in the enemy phase they move a bit differently. So the encounter card is Trilogue. So swarming 2, barring it spawns at the burning pit. And we are a bit tight on table space, so we'll just spawn it up here. Then mark it down. Okay, so we are getting a lot of enemies, which isn't that nice because we are lacking a weapon. Okay, well, at the moment I think we need to let those guys, the red one will kill off the blue, but we could defeat this. Actually, we can't afford to let the red one defeat the blue, because then if we kill the green one, the red ones will start to snowball. So I think we are heading down, killing the blue one, killing the red one. So move, engage, and hit. We are hitting 4 versus 2. And I think we don't spend anything. Even the skull, well, yeah, there are only skulls as extra symbols in the back, so hopefully we hit. It's a zero, so we hit, kill this cultist off. And that is our whole turn. Okay, so the enemy phase, this moves here. Blue doesn't. Red moves here. Blue doesn't move, so we hit. The green one hits the blue and defeats it. And the red one doesn't hit anything, and there are no blue enemies. So the green ones got one doom onto their agenda for killing the blue one. That was unavoidable, but it is what it is. Next turn, we might need to go punch some trilogogs or do something like that, or let them kill the. Maybe we let them kill the green ones, but that all depends on which order they are activating. Just this a bit. Okay, so we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get nautical prowess, which is really good, and we get one resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. So again, first we randomize the order. Red, blue, green. Okay. So I'm thinking we just let these guys battle it out. These red ones will kill off the last cultist, so we really need one blue. So after we have no cultist enemies, we can advance, which is really important. But of course the red ones will get more doom, but it is that's unavoidable at the moment. So the enemy, the mythos phase continues with the encounter card. While they sleep, for each faction that has the most enemies in play, place one doom on the faction's agenda. If no enemies are in play, place no doom. Okay, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I think this counts as three, so I think the red ones get a doom. If not, then comment down in the comments if I should have added the greens, but I think there is three different enemies. Each count as a different enemy, even if they are under a swarming card. So my understanding is that this count as three, and this is only one. But I might be mistaken. So that was the mythos phase. We go to the investigation phase. Let's think about this a bit. I think we'll move to the Street of Providence. It's a four-shot location with one clue. Actually, we could pay for the movement, so we have more actions to spend. We'll play the new keyring. We'll use the keyring to investigate. I will commit resource. Maybe not. I'll commit the marcher nautical prowess to the test. So I'm investigating 4 versus 2. It's a -1. It's a negative modifier. I will let this go, but I'll draw a card. So I get nimble. And I'll get this clue, and we spend one source from here. Then, last action, I think we'll move down to the arcade. And that is our turn. The enemy phase starts. Red one moves first. Green, no blue enemies, green don't move, red one hits first, so they just defeat this enemy here. And We add one doom to the red agenda. They're really close of popping, but it is what it is. No other enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a chainsaw. Okay, well, if we are stopping investigating, we could just play chainsaw and start murdering everything with it. And we gain one resource. So that's a good card for later turns. So we keep it at hand. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Let's randomize the order. Not a big of matter this turn, as there is only red enemies. Oh yeah, and at the end of the last round, well, we'll do this. I will do this at the start of the investigation phase, so we advance then. So, actually, we'll do it in the mythos phase. Let's do it at the end of the last round, just because if I draw a cultist, it stops me from doing anything. So we'll advance. So a portal opens. We put the hub dimension location in play, and I'll just place the hub dimension here. It's not connected to anything at the moment. Then we'll add the doom to all of the agendas. So yeah, green, blue, green, red, and blue. So the blue faction is way behind each other. So we get the Feast of Locusts. Test willpower 2. Increase the difficulty of this test by 1 for each swarm card in play. There are 2 swarm cards. If you fail, take 2 horror. If you fail by 4 or more, instead take 3 horror. So this is really nasty. I don't have any willpower icons. So unfortunately, I'm testing blind, and it's 2 versus. Two versus four for this test. So I'm down by 2, and I'm down by 3, which means I only take 2 horror. But still, I'll take 1 on Madame LaBranche and 1 on myself. Okay, that is the mythos space. So let's see. Yeah, this is only warring, so it just is there. It doesn't do anything at the moment, so we don't have to mind that much. But I think we are starting to get some clues from here. I think we are. Yeah, so we need 6 clues onto the hub dimension to advance. Let's see if we can just we can basically use our agility here in the arcade to get clues, but I think we can also do some investigating. So first thing is to investigate. I'll just use the old key ring. So I'm investigating 2 versus 0. It's a 0. We spent the last clue from here. We get the resource from there, and we get the clue. Second action, I'll use resourceful and nimble to do the test here. It's a -3. So we actually fail this. That is a bummer. So I'll pull the resourceful back with Silas's ability. Then I'll try again for my last action. It's a -2. We fail again. Well, this is not looking that good. Okay, that was our turn. Enemy phase. Nothing happens. Upkeep. We ready. Draw a card. We get quick thinking and gain one resource. Okay, well, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We determine the faction order. We have red, green, and... Okay. We add doom, so the red one advances. Green is advancing next turn, and blue is advancing the turn after that. So, we add one Elderthin token to the back. We shuffle three of the set aside Trilogox to three, along with the Transmogrifice. And spawn the remaining set aside Trilogox enemy. Gains an additional two swarming. Okay. Just place it here. So, these go into the counter deck. And it gains additional two swarming, so we put four cards underneath it, which is not really nice. We really need a we could just chainsaw it twice or something like that, but at the moment it's just staying there in the burning pit. We can just ignore it at the moment. The encounter card for this turn is Feast of Locusts, so we are not passing this one, so it's there are six, so it's 8 versus 2, so we're just out of failing it, and yeah, we could die from this horror, so we take 1, 2, 3, we are one way from going insane. That is a bummer. Well, hopefully we don't, but that might happen. First action. We'll actually play the chainsaw. I'll exhaust Madame LeBronze to draw a card. Okay, we'll play the Cherished Keepsake. So a bit more horror soak for us. And last action, we'll try the agility test here, and I'll use quick thinking. So, 5 versus 4. And auto fail, so I'll pull this quick thinking back. And enemy phase, nothing happens. We got upkeep, we draw Peter Sylvester. Nice. And we gain a resource. So I think next turn we need to play Peter to get more horror soak onto the table to stay alive. But that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We determine the faction order again. We have blue, green, and red. Okay, we have doom, so basically advance the green one. We add a cultist to the back. And two Bringer of Paradises get shuffled to the deck with the encounter discard pile. Also, hunt downs go into the deck. We don't spawn the horrific Shoko, at least. Okay. Then we get an encounter card. It's Hellfire, test agility 4. If you fail, either take 2 damage or face 2 of your clues. Well, we can take a lot of damage, so we'll just test 4 versus 4. It's a 0, so we actually pass the test. First action, I'll exhaust Madame Branch to get a... Well, I can't get a resource. Actually, last turn we misplayed because I took a card and I had cards in hand, so we actually would have. Yeah, I think first action we'll just draw a card. We get Peter. Again, resource. So I can play Peter next turn, and I'll try the agility test again. And it's a skull, it's a minus one. Now we succeed. I can't pull this back, so... And we don't get an extra action, but we gain one extra crew from the token pool. So, enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep. Card, we get another chainsaw, and we gain one resource, so we have enough for Peter next turn. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Let's randomize the faction order. So red, green, and blue. We add Doom, so red, green, and blue advances. We add a tablet to the bag. We shuffle two of the set aside. Eternal entities and the inevitable ends into the deck, along with the discard. Okay, then we get an encounter card, which is Ravagers of War. Each non-elite enemy moves and attacks as if it were the enemy phase. Enemies do not exhaust after attacking in this wave. No attacks were made as a result of this effect. Ravagers of War get surge. These don't have hunter, so they don't move. There are no warring enemies that they would move against, so this on gets surge. They don't attack anything, and we get the Bringer of Paradise. So, well, finally some action onto the warring side of the table. Don't think it's that good of a thing, but at least it is what it is. First action will play Peter Sylvester, and as we have Charisma, we can have it Peter and Madame LeBronze play at the same time. So we pull. Boost our agility, so I'll try the agility test here. 5 versus 4. It's a minus 1, so we gain 1 clue. Last action, I'll do the same. 5 versus 4 again. And it's an auto fail, so we just fail it. Enemy phase. So now the red ones move first, this moves here, this moves here, and then this moves here. And no blue enemies, so these will kill off the Bringer of Paradise. Which will add one doom to the red agenda. Okay, well, no other enemy movement or attack, so we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get a second church keepsake, so we are set with the horror soaks, and we gain one resource. Actually, I now could have used Madame Lebrun's to gain resource, so I'll go back to the enemy phase and use Lightning Bolt window to do that, so we get another resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We randomized the faction order again. Green, blue, red. So nothing major happening. We had Dooms. Green, blue, red. Concarnies while they sleep, so we add one doom to the red agenda, which is here advancing. That isn't good. I think first action we need to try and get more of the clues from the arcade. We need 6 clues here. And there's only one here, so I need 2 more clues with the arcade test here. So 5 versus 4. I don't have anything to boost it with, so we get a 0. We get 1 clue. We do that action again. Another 0, so we get another clue. Just checking, there are no restrictions that you can't do it multiple times a turn. The last action will move to the Athenaeum of the Empty Sky. So next turn, this is a ritual site, so we can start pumping clues to the hub dimension. And there is 1 clue. Shroud of 3, so I think we are trying to investigate the last clue from here. So, enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, we draw a card through the gates. We lose Madame Lebrun. So that was not nice. And we gain 1 resource. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We do the faction order again. Yeah, this should be dead already. So red, blue, and green. So we add the dooms, red advances, blue gets one, and green gets one. We add another Elder Thing token to the back. There are no Trilogues set aside. And we put the Droning Horde into the Burning Pit. Okay, well, there goes the rest of my deck almost, so it's swarming 6. Just place it here because it's otherwise it's out of the view. But it starts in the burning pit. So let's see. That is all that happens. Let's look at the Droning Horde. So it's Hunter, it's 3 fight, 1 health per swarm card, and 3 evade. Monster, Insect, Servitor, Elite, Hunter, Swarm 6. Post after Droning Horde enters play, each investigator chooses a card from their hand and places it face down underneath an insect enemy as a swarm card. I'll just choose the Cherished Keepsake. And it goes underneath this one. When Drowning Horror attacks, it deals either its damage or its horror instead of both. And it's victory point 1. So I think let's say focus. Yeah, well, this guy will start hunting us, so at least we have the chainsaw, and with that it, I think it's quite easy to mow it down. But first thing we need to do is start pumping out this and just wait for it to come. So, we'll go to the encounter card, and it is a Bringer of Paradise. So this, the green dudes are just feeding the reds to victory, but nothing I can do about it. Okay, investigation phase, we'll investigate here. I'll just investigate 2 versus 3. Minus 3. We'll investigate again. 2 versus 3. It's a minus 1, but I'll play the look what I found so I get this clue. And last action, we'll put 1. Here and test willpower 2. We are testing 3 versus 2. And it's a skull, so it's minus 5, so we fail, but that's okay. Well, we really need to succeed at least a couple of times or we'll run out of time, but it is what it is. Enemy phase, red, this guy moves here. And this is a hunt. This guy moves here. This is hunter. Warring. And that's the enemy movement. And then red ones hit. So these guys hit and kill the green ones. We add a doom to the red agenda. Then upkeep, we draw a card, we get Derringer, and we gain 1 resource. So if we run out of chainsaw, choose. We have another chainsaw and a Derringer. So at least we have wasted 5. But that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Let's randomize the order again. So red, green, blue. I think this might be more interesting variant if I was playing multiplayer game and there were a lot of more different factions in play and the red ones wouldn't be just killing off the other factions each turn. Oh yeah, we add the dooms, green, well, red, green and blue. Counter card is Inevitable End. You must decide, choose 1, place 1 doom on the blue agenda, choose 3 cards in your hand, well, just place 1 doom on the blue agenda. Blues are so far behind. Then, first action, I'll put 1 clue here. I'll test 3 versus 2. It's a minus 4. If you fail, place 1 card committed to this test. Well, I don't have any cards committed, so I'll just place another clue here and test 3 versus 2. It's a skull, it's a minus 3, so I fail, and I'll do it again. 3 versus 2. An Elder Sign, so actually I think I'll grab nautical prowess and commit it to the test, and I'll draw a card with it. So we managed one more clue here. So next turn we can seal off the up dimension if we are still alive at that point. But yeah, enemy phase, only red enemies, but this is a hunter, so it hunts here. Upkeep, we draw a card, we get track shoes a bit late, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We randomize the order again. So green, blue, and red. We add the dooms. Green, blue, and red. Encounter card is Hellfire. I'll just test the agility. I'm agility 5. I'll actually commit the track shoes. One of the derringers to the test. So I'm 7 versus 4. It's a minus 1. I'll just succeed. And I'll put the 6th clue as first action here. So we get to advance. If your group has sealed off the hub dimension, advance. If you are playing in single group mode, when your work is done, you and your companions lie in on the cold ground, your skin tingling with otherworldly currents. The night sky is filled with stars and no longer blotted out by the swirling black entities or alternate dimensions spotted in uncanny mist. The investigators have sealed Earth away from the cataclysmic war of the Outer Gods, Resolution 1. The hub's many doorways are now sealed tight under your stern control. With the hub sealed, the cults fighting over the ownership should hopefully return to operating in secrecy, perhaps waiting for a time when the hub reopens and they can use it to advance their current cruel agendas. Until then, the Earth is safe, relatively speaking. So I could add the Cloak of Outer Realm story asset to Silas's deck and the Pocket Portal story asset. And I would gain victory, and I would gain only one victory from there, plus 2 bonus for preventing all of the other gods from completing their seams. So, okay, well. I think the variant is interesting, maybe in a multiplayer game, in a solo game where you basically just try to stop there being only one faction on the table, so there are not warring factions that would fight each other. It doesn't do that much. It might affect the order in which these solve, if the doom gets added in a different order, that might change the situation. In this game, the red were in a clear lead from the start, so it didn't affect anything. But still, I really like this scenario. I had the chance to play it in an epic multiplayer with around near 100 players. And our group had 3 players, so in multiplayer, this scenario is really fun, and the epic multiplayer version is really fun too. So if you have a chance to try that out, I recommend it. But if you are a mostly solo player as myself, I still recommend this scenario. Most of my previous games have gone that the green is in the lead. This was the first time that the red faction was in the lead. And in the epic multiplayer, the blue was in the lead. So it changes the flow of the scenario a bit, whichever faction starts to get ahead. But yeah, that is War of the Outer Gods with the randomized variant. thanks for watching, and until next time.